Hey guys, it's Alicia, and today I'm going to show you how to set up a WordPress staging site. A staging site lets you transfer mundane and potential site-breaking tasks to a copy of your site. The live website will remain online and error-free. Meanwhile, you can work on whatever you need to and push the changes live when you're ready. In this video, we'll explore some easy ways to set up a staging site for your WordPress. Before we get too far though, I want to let you know there will be links to more resources in the video's description. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. All right then, let's get started. Let's look into setting up a WordPress staging site using a few different methods. Our first method is one that not all web hosts will offer. Dedicated staging functionality is often the domain of top quality WordPress hosts because they know the value of a staging site. For example, DevKinsta offers one-click staging, and we'll showcase this in more detail later. Where a host does offer built-in staging, there are often two elements in place. As we've noted, one-click staging is popular because this represents the fastest way to stage your live site. And a WordPress staging site will reside on a subdomain of your primary domain. If you're a DevKinsta customer, we've discussed WordPress staging in detail on our knowledge base. You might want to read through that as well. Your staging environment will have its own subdomain and will carry over your secure sockets layer settings too. You can even restore a site backup to staging and push your staging site live from the MyKinsta dashboard. We think our staging functionality is second to none. Even so, there's icing to pipe onto the three-tiered cake courtesy of DevKinsta. The MyKinsta dashboard has almost all of the features and functionality you need to create and manage your live site. If you prefer working in a local environment, you can use DevKinsta. DevKinsta is our local development environment for all web developers and site owners, though it has specific functionality for Kinsta customers. It's a full-featured app to help you create new WordPress sites with a minimum of clicks. In addition, it has lots in the box to help you get things ready for a real server. Here's one setting that we want to focus on a little more, the push to staging option. This feature allows you to choose a target site and transfer your local site to your staging environment. It also means you have a way to stay entirely within the Kinsta ecosystem throughout the entire development journey. The first step in the process is to import your site from Kinsta within DevKinsta. Once your site is hosted within DevKinsta, you can take your time to make the changes you need. From there, you'll click the Push to Staging button and send it back to your hosting server. When you're ready to unleash your site into the world, the Push to Live button within the MyKinsta dashboard will get the job done. We mentioned that some hosts wouldn't let you create a WordPress staging site. Of course, we'd recommend switching providers if this applies to you, but there are still ways to create a staging environment if you can't. Given that WordPress's plugin ecosystem is robust, it's no surprise that staging plugins also exist. For the unaware, a staging plugin gives you near parity in functionality as a host does, but handled from your WordPress dashboard. That said, it's worth noting that there are some differences between staging plugins and other site duplication plugins, such as Duplicator. For starters, Duplicator isn't for staging. It's a powerful plugin to clone a website, but it doesn't have the pseudo version control that a staging environment has. We've seen site duplication plugins recommended as an ideal way to create a staging site. We don't recommend it. It's arguable whether using a plugin such as Duplicator is on par with a dedicated local development tool such as DevKinsta. Instead, there are beefier solutions such as WP Stagecoach and WP Staging. The benefits of using a solution such as WP Staging are numerous. You're able to clone your site fast. Everything happens within a familiar-looking dashboard. You can exclude specific database tables and folders. You can choose which files and tables are pushed live. The whole process of using a plugin will feel familiar. Concerning WP Staging, you'll install the plugin on your site in the usual way. Note that there's a free version with limited functionality and a premium version that offers the full range of features. Once the plugin is on your site, you'll head to the WP Staging, then Sites and Start page, and click the Create New Staging Site button. Clicking this will bring you to the scanning section. There are three parts here you should consider apart from entering a name for your staging site: database tables, files, and advanced settings or pro. Database tables. This is a list of all your database tables, and you're able to select whichever ones you'd like to stage. Files. You can choose which folders to copy here, along with any extra directories you'd like to copy. And advanced settings and pro. There are plenty of settings here. For example, you can copy your staging site to a separate database, to a custom directory, and you can also symlink your production site's uploads. Once you click to continue, you'll begin the cloning and staging process. When the plugin is finished, you'll see the details you need to work on your staging site. When you access your staging site, the toolbar will be bright orange, a deterrent in case you do the unthinkable. From here, you can push your changes back to production and manage your staging site from the WordPress dashboard. Our final method for setting up a WordPress staging site is the toughest and not as functional. We're hard-pressed to recommend it in all but the most extreme and niche use cases. Creating a manual WordPress staging site is as it sounds. You'll build all of the components you need and deploy your site without automation for the most part. There are a few severe drawbacks with this approach. A manual approach means there's a higher chance of errors creeping into your workflow. There's no way to sync site data between installations. And you're not able to push selected data, tables, or files between installations. In other words, you're creating a manual version of a plugin such as Duplicator. Even so, you could see some benefits if you use the approach to your advantage. For example, you could set up a staging site to test a narrow range of features and functionality, such as a WordPress core update. Once you're happy that it works on your staging site, you can apply the changes to your live site. Of course, you're duplicating the work you need to do, and this is another drawback in the process. Despite this, your situation and needs will determine whether a manual staging site is for you. If so, you'll need the following. A hosting provider that lets you create subdomains, admin access to your hosting backend, and working knowledge of the SQL language. Once you have these in place, make sure you've carried out a full backup of your site. Creating a manual WordPress staging site is fraught with danger, and you'll be thankful for your backup if the worst happens. There are 7 general steps you need to set up a manual staging site. First, create a new subdomain in your web host's control panel. Set up a dedicated secure file transfer protocol account for your staging site. Upload your WordPress files to staging server. The best way is to install a fresh version of your WordPress, then upload your themes, plugins, and uploads folders. Export your database from your live site and create a new database for your staging site within your hosting control panel. Now import the database to your staging server using an SQL manager such as Adminer. Lastly, update wp-config-php to reflect your staging site. How you achieve some of these aspects is up to you and your host. Despite the complexity involved, each method is within the scope of even a beginner user. That said, the time it takes to implement may not be worth the hassle. Of course, if you set up a manual WordPress staging site, you also have to deploy it yourself. There's often a one-click option with an automated approach, which isn't available in this instance. If you're a back-end dev with high expertise in PHP and SQL, you may be able to implement the automatic deployment, though we're betting this isn't your situation here. As such, we recommend replicating the changes you make on your staging site rather than trying to deploy them. Kinsta's WordPress hosting can speed up your website by up to 200%, and you'll get 24/7 support from our expert WordPress engineers. Let us show you the Kinsta difference. Try a free demo of our My Kinsta dashboard at demo.kinsta.com. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.